everybody. I am Tanisha Dunlap with Nariah's Way Foundation.
I'm Tisha Little with Mothers Against Violence.
And today is June 5th, which is Gun Violence Awareness Day all over the world. And I know you guys are used to us having an event at the park, releasing balloons in honor of those who have lost their lives to gun violence. But today we are coming to you virtually because we are not able to do anything due to the coronavirus.
Mothers Against Violence is very important to keep on raising awareness against gun violence till we get a solution to it. We are the solution to raising awareness to guns against violence, to have it stop, so we can, you know, clear up everything so it can stop.
That's right. And so, like I said, again, today, all over the world, we are just honoring those who have lost their lives to gun violence. Tasha and I both know how hard it is to navigate through life without closure because of losing our loved ones. And we are just here to just give you this video to encourage those who have lost a loved one out there due to gun violence, to that we are still praying with you guys. We are here with you guys. If you ever need us, Mothers Against Violence is here. And I'm also here helping the children during the aftermath part, helping them with grief therapy.
Yeah. And I want to tell you a little bit about Mothers Against Violence, or the ones that don't know about the organization. It's been here in Montgomery County for at least 3 years now, whenever I experienced the tragedy of losing loved ones. And it's a lot of people that face, a lot of mothers mm-hmm. that face these tragedies with their children, or whether it's a spouse, or due to gun violence. And my organization is here to support anything that you need, because I know whenever I was going through it, I always looked for a solution. Mm-hmm. I always looked for someone to help me make it through. And what's more better than a person that understands right. where you are coming from? Along with Nariah's Way, mm-hmm. Tanisha going to tell you a little bit about her organization, but I have a testimony with her organization, which I have a 12-year-old daughter that joined her organization right. shortly, like 3 years ago, and it really don't help her a whole lot to cope with the loss of her dad and the other family members that she had lost that was really close to her. And as a mother, you know, that organizations like this really don't help me to get through the hard times, the good times, mm-hmm. and everything else, because Tanisha can reach her in a way that I cannot reach her mm-hmm. because she have a child that's dealing with the same thing. Mm-hmm. Again, with Mothers Against Violence, like I can reach her
to help the kids.
Yeah. So coming together and uniting with our organization, it have been awesome.
It really has.
Throughout the years.
Events that we've put on those have lost their lives to gun violence, it has been really great. Yeah. The outcome has been great. The support that the community has given us has been amazing.
Really amazing.
Yeah.
Really amazing.
And we really hate that we can't do it this year, but we will definitely plan something for 2021 to be able to come together again
and get better and bigger every year.
It does.
So, you know, I thank God mm-hmm. for giving me the vision to me. This is a ministry to me, to help others mm-hmm. to get through this, because it's really hard. So, you know, right now, I don't know if everyone knows about Mothers Against Violence or know about Nariah's Way, but we can tell you a little bit about it mm-hmm. and just see how, you know, whoever sees this can reach out
and follow. You need us.
During this time. So if you want to go ahead and start, you can.
Okay. Well, Nariah's Way Foundation, we help children that have lost a parent in the act of senseless gun violence. And our focus is grief therapy. So it's really important for children who have their whole life ahead of them to get some type of therapy, because with each age limit, with each age, there comes a different emotion. You know, different emotions rise up at different ages. So it's really important for them to get some type of therapy and to be able to heal, mm-hmm. you know. And it's even better when you got other children that can mirror their type of their hurt, mm-hmm. and they can be around them and share, you know, their experiences. So my goal is just to help them with grief therapy so that they can express their feelings and be able to vent it out to someone, even if it's not me, but someone who is at home, or just if they're at school and they can't talk to their parents at home, whoever it may be, just to have that outlet for them to be able to share their emotions.
And also, it's a with me having a child that's in her organization, it really gives them motivation. It's a mentor thing, because I have shared, I don't know if I can share it with
her. That's fine.
I have shared it with her. Like, my daughter, she, Tanisha is really a big mentor to her, an idol, because she, mm-hmm. she said, "Mama, I want to be an entrepreneur. I want to go into photography." And I remember when y'all had the entrepreneur camp, it really had motivated her. And I think that's a blessing with everything that these kids have endured, mm-hmm. the hurt and pain. This still giving them the mindset that we still, even though this happened to me in my life,
right,
I still can go on.
Yes.
I still can, you know, be an entrepreneur.
Yes.
I still
this
don't have to break me.
Right.
You know.
Right.
And it's very important whenever, especially when they are going into their preteen.
Mm-hmm. Because both of us have you know, preteens right now.
It's a really, guys, I encourage anybody that's dealing with a loss and their children is dealing with, please reach out to Nariah's Way. It's really such a blessing. It has been a blessing to me. And I know it has been a blessing to someone else. And I appreciate you, Tanisha, for it.
Thank
you.
You
know,
you
I
guys.
Agree with you. It's really good.
It is. I mean, it even helps me, you know, to be able to see them, you know, it just melts my heart. I'm just glad that they all can be around one another and just see that they are not alone in this situation.
Yeah.
And if you guys, if you want to follow us on Facebook, you can. It is Nariah's Way Foundation. And on Instagram, it's just Nariah's Way.
Okay, great.
Tell us about Mother's Gives
Violence, y'all. I'm very excited, because I'm telling you what, I am a mother that experienced a big tragedy 3 years ago. And just, you know, I have older children, but I do have, you know, a preteen. And it doesn't matter, mothers, you know, it doesn't matter how old your children get. You always going to be that nurturing person. And whenever they hurt, you hurt.
Mm-hmm.
So just being a mother that had to deal with a big tragedy, a big part of our life, it motivated me to be that spokesperson, to be the voice for the voiceless. Like, a lot of times, mothers, we weigh things heavy on our chest, and we try to be so strong for our kids to say, okay, I can't break. I cannot break. I got to be there for them. But all at the same time, we have to take care of ourselves.
That's
and
true.
We need mothers to help us be strong, other people to go through. And that's what Mothers Against Violence is for.
Mm-hmm.
I am here for the mothers that just need that extra talk, the mother that just need that extra booth. I know November is National Grief Awareness Month.
It is.
And I always hold a conference, a grief conference, for people to come out, and I invite different mothers or different people to come out and tell their testimonies and how they have overcome. That was my thing last year to this year, to how to overcome of getting through a tragedy of a loved one, or dealing with the being a mother to kids that's some lost loved ones, their dad and mom and their family. So that's what Mothers Against Violence is for. And I'm just here. I do most of my stuff through email. If you need to email at littletashia1@gmail.com to reach out to me and send me an email if you just need to talk. I'm on Facebook. Mothers Against Violence, send me a message if you need to talk. I will message you my phone number. I'm here. I will take call any time of night, because
she will.
As you know, as a mother, when everything get the quiet, the house get silent,
yeah,
everything get quiet,
Your mind gets to wandering.
Yeah. It gets to going, and you always need, I always need someone to talk to. Mm-hmm. I'm here. I'm no counselor. I'm no licensed counselor, but I can share my story. I can share my testimony and what helped me to overcome. Mm-hmm. So, you know, I'm here, Mothers Against Violence. If we can help in any kind of way, I try to partner up with Tanisha. Mm-hmm. If your kids need anything, mm-hmm. you know, we try to, you know, step out there and see what we can do. I'm here for that. Also, just reach out. This is what we do. This is a ministry to me. You know, a lot of people don't like to reach out, and they'll say, well, I don't want to tell my business. Uh-huh. Trust me, believe me, whatever we talk about
is confidential.
Definitely. I don't share with anyone else. Right. You know, I don't try to give medical advice, but I'm very spiritual, and I really trust God in mm-hmm. everything I do. So I will tell you what the wisdom that God have gave me to tell you. So that's just what Muslim Against Violence is for. Mm-hmm. We are a nonprofit organization. Yeah. We don't ask for any money or anything. Mm-hmm. So, you know, reach out to us. You know, we here. It's something here in the county, surrounding counties, that can right. help. You know, you're not alone. You do not have to fight this alone.
That's right. Yeah. And like we said, we thank you guys for tuning in. Today is National Gun Violence Awareness Day, June 5th. Wear your orange. You can still tag us in a picture. Even if you don't want to post it on your page, you can send it to our inbox. Yeah. And we can post it on our page if that is okay with you. But we still want to bring awareness to the fact that people are still getting gunned down each and every day. By tons of people. So mm-hmm. we just want to bring awareness to that and still share some love to those who lost their lives to gun violence.
And also, you know, I had mentioned the month of June, mm-hmm. you know, starting after what, June the 5th. Uh-huh. If you want to send in your loved one's name, honor them on that day mm-hmm. through our Facebook page or through Messenger, Mothers Against Violence or Nariah Way. Yeah. Whenever we see it, we can post their names.
Mm-hmm.
Or if you want to write a short comment or you want to go on mm-hmm. our page, we will share, tag, and post. Or how we want to honor them, the ones that would have been affected mm-hmm. by gun violence altogether. And later on in the year, maybe next year, we're going to try to do like a kind of like visual movie.
Yep, we are.
So we have a lot of plans. Mothers Against Violence have plans to do things. I know the right way.
Yeah, we
have
do.
Plans to do things with the kids.
We can't wait.
Yes, it's just like COVID-19 just came and interrupted everything.
Right.
But, you know, we here by phone, emails, messenger, Facebook, however, we are here.
We
still want to encourage everyone to reach out
us.
So we're here for you.
That's right.
Yeah.
And until next year, y'all stay tuned. Please follow us on Facebook and just reach out and see the updates and everything. And we thank you guys for tuning in again.
All right. Bye.
All right. Bye-bye.